Regis University's Department of Fine and Performing Arts is proud to host the 2015 Inspired Thinker, playwright, actor, and musician Daniel Valdez. In January of 1966, at the age of 17, Daniel Valdez joined his brother, Luis Valdez, to fight for the unjust treatment of farm workers and joined Cesar Chavez and the United Farm Workers Union. Daniel was one of the founding members of the El Teatro Campesino, and while on the picket lines, Valdez learned to do theater, and incorporate his music to bring the message of the United Farm Workers Union to farm workers. 1973 marked the record recording of the first Chicano album by a major label, A&M Records. Mestizo was Valdez's first solo album, and it propelled him into the world of concert performer. Daniel has been seen in many film productions, including the Chicano classic Zoot Suit, for which he wrote the original music, arranged all of the classic 1940s big band music, and was the central actor. Daniel has been seen in film productions. In 1987, Daniel realized a 13-year dream when the life story of Richie Valens was brought to the silver screen in the movie La Bamba, which he and his brother wrote and produced. Daniel has been seen in other major feature films such as Which Way Is Up, starring Richard Pryor, and The China Syndrome with Jane Fonda, Jack Lemmon, and Michael Douglas. He has also appeared in Cheech Marin's Born in East L.A. Mr. Valdez has also performed with many well-known musicians. He was a romantic lead opposite Linda Ronstadt in her stage production of Canciones de Mi Padre. He has also worked and performed with other musician artists such as Carlos Santana, Jerry Garcia, Ruben Blades, Celia Cruz, and Tito Puente in the critically acclaimed Cinemax Special Latin Sessions. Along with Valdez's list of stage, film, and musical credits, he has always worked with the community organizations and schools as a positive role model for Hispanic youth, with special guest lectures, performances, workshops, and benefits for these organizations. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in a warm applause for Daniel Valdez.
Well, happy 16 September. Yes. We get independence from somewhere. Before I start, I'd like to dedicate the show tonight to my late great wife. She just passed. She was the one who actually organized this performance, and we were both planning to come here and spend some time here. But it's for her I do this show. How can we begin to express what America means to the Chicano? We are Indios, Mestizos, Hispanos, Mexicanos. The names have all been changed across the centuries, but they all mean the same thing. We have been Americanos longer than America has existed. For the ancient Indio, America offers a legacy that rivals the culture of the Egyptian. It is a legacy etched in stone. Skeletal remains of a gentle, fierce, and scientific people. America, America, yo me acuerdo de ti. America, America, I remember you, America, from our first bloody sweat amidst the dirt and the leaves, brown and shiny in the dim lights of jacales, with Indio eyes and European skulls and black hair, a flame of microcosmic life, vida, hope, esperanza. En donde estás el indio de ayer, en esta América y en esta tierra vivió. ¿Dónde está el indio de ayer? Que jamás ya volvimos a ver. We were the blood of two worlds brought together in the rape of Mexico, Chile, Peru. And on top, the memory of Galicia, Andalusia, Castilla, and below, the fear of gods. Huichilopochtli, Cuautlicue, Tezcatlipoca. And between the memory and fear, we came forth alive with our tongues crying out. For we were el sol, Donatillo, spiked with infinitesimal radiance, el sol contained as in the ancient fistful of a human heart. Beating, beating, proceeding, receding, el puñao sagrado de la vida. And the earth, la tierra, was ours. A voice cried out amongst the bushes and the leaves, like a deadly ocelot, pounding its clawed paws on the grass clump ground, swinging right and then left, and then pausing, and then rushing forth with powerful thighs to leap upon his victim, Mestizo! Raza by our padres, and they with our madres had barely matched half with half to bear in us a race of whole human beings. America, America, yo me acuerdo de ti. So who are we? Where do we come from? Where do our families come from? That's what it's all about. It's about identity and who we are. In 1965, the strike broke out in California, where farm workers for the first time stood up to fight for their rights. A man whose name was Cesar Chavez left an imprint in America that changed the face of the country. It was a time when labor was a very important thing, but no one had really paid any attention to the farm worker. At the age of 17, I went to Delano, actually to go visit my brother, and I never left. It kept me there. I walked into the Filipino hall. There were 2,000 farm workers in there. And I couldn't believe how many people were in there. You know, kids, dogs, everybody. You know, they were all on strike. It was amazing, absolutely amazing. And the energy of that place was incredible. And we walked in, and I ran into something that I will never forget. The heart and soul of our people.
Trabajadores campesinos, al luchar con valor y con tesón, sin dar pasos para atrás, todos unidos, al luchar en contra del patrón. Nuestra unión está nuestra victoria y el final de una vil explotación. Para nadie ambas suelos de miseria y jamás malos tratos del patrón. Viva la causa por cual luchamos, viva la huelga en el fin. Viva la Virgen de Guadalupe, viva nuestra unión. A temblar, patroncitos barateros, contratista, el cruel explotador, mayordomos y todos sus lacayos, ya el campesino tiene protección. Campesinos mexicanos, americanos de color, Puerto Rico y filipinos, todos son de igual valor. Viva la causa por cual luchamos, viva la huelga en el fin. Viva la Virgen de Guadalupe, viva nuestra unión. Viva la causa por cual luchamos, viva la huelga en el fin. Viva la Virgen de Guadalupe, viva nuestra unión.
¡Viva la huelga!
It was quite an experience to see farm workers fighting for their rights. You know, it was hard to get farm workers to come out of the fields. And in the process of all this energy that was taking place in Delano, we started our own theater company, El Teatro Campesino, which we're celebrating 50 years this year, 50 years of actually surviving. Thank you. And on the 26th of September, the union is celebrating 50 years of the strike. And they're bringing together all of the other original people who were originally involved in the strike in Delano. The amazing thing for me, I was 17 years old. I mean, I had a Beatle haircut, you know? I had Beatle boots. And I look really strange amongst all these farm workers. They saw me, and Cesar got up and said, "This is Luis Valdez's brother, Daniel," right? And I felt kind of strange. It was an exposure to me that left my heart filled with so much energy. I had never been around so many Mexicans in all my life. I mean, it was an amazing feeling. It was a feeling of family. And the thing that got me the most were the kids, the children. You know, the one thing people don't talk about is that the union outlawed and created a movement that changed the labor laws in the country. It used to be that kids could work in the field, little kids. I mean, I started picking by the time I was 3 years old. You know, and I picked until I was 13 years old. You know, and I remember my father used to tell me, "Andale, chingale, chingale." You know, "Un dime es un dime," you know. And I had a little lard can, Armistar lard can, you know. And I would pick stuff and put it in there. But it was the act of changing the labor laws that made the difference. Because it's really about the kids. We were fighting for rights. We were fighting for decent wages. We were fighting for decent living conditions. We're asking farm workers to go out on strike. But the kids are the ones who took most of the blow. I mean, for some of you who've ever grown up in a farm working family and worked in the fields, I mean, there was always a competition between families, you know. The more pickers there were, the better there were. I remember families of 18 members of the family, right, would go into a field, and chinga, 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 and then, and literally, that crop was gone, you know? While I was in Delano, I met these two young Chicanos who had written a poem, and it inspired me. And then I heard them perform. And I loved the piece, and I loved their poetry and their song. Thank you. up to California. From Mexico you come to the Sacramento Valley to toil in the sun. Your wife and seven children, they're working, everyone. And what will you be given to your brown-eyed children of the sun? Your faces lined and wrinkled, and your age is 41. Your back is bent from peeking, like your dying time has come. Your children's eyes smiling, their lives have just begun. And what will you be given to your brown-eyed children of the sun? You marched on Easter Sunday to the Capitol, you come. You fought for union wages, and your fight had just begun. You're a proud man, you're a free man, and this heritage is one that you can be given to your brown-eyed children of the sun. So kids, the kids were the most important thing, you know. And Cesar used to say, you know, we're going on strike so our kids don't have to live the way we did, the conditions that we lived in. I mean, there were no bathrooms in the fields. We lived in labor camps, which the grower would take out of your check. You know, he'd give you a ride to work every morning, you take it out of your check. So by the time you got your check, there was nothing left, you know. So the children are the ones who bore a lot of that pain, you know. And we used to talk a lot to the farm workers about los hijos. That was the other thing, you know, going to Delano, back to Delano, at the age of 17, I couldn't speak a word of Spanish anymore. When I started school, I couldn't speak English at all. By the time I got out of high school, I couldn't speak Spanish. It was gone, literally gone. And so going to Delano for me was really a re-identification with myself and who I was. Going out to those picket lines and yelling to those phones, "Oye, compañero, véngase pa' acá." And they turn around and say, "¿Qué quieres?" And I go, no sapo inglés. But it was the children who were the most important thing about the union. We wrote a song about those kids in the farm working fields, Delano in California. And it was always about getting up in the morning. You get up at 5-4 o'clock in the morning, you know, and go to work, you know. And I remember the tacos we used to have at lunch. They were all greasy and full of chorizo, and the papas, you know. It was an experience like you couldn't believe. For the longest time, I didn't know I was poor. You know, we actually lived in an army tent in an actual orchard. And I remember I went to school that year, and I think it was in the third grade, and they said, what did you do for summer? And everybody goes, well, we went camping, we went to Yosemite, and we went to this place. And they got to me and said, what did you do? I said, we went camping. I mean, for the longest time, I thought we were related to Abraham Lincoln because we had a pole in the middle of our living room, you know. And I remember the floor. My mother used to clean it so much. It literally glistened. It was made of dirt. But she had swept it and cleaned it so much it looked like mahogany, you know. So it was to them that we wrote the song. And we said it in the, as they say in the morning, levántate, cabrón. Como a las una, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis de la mañana. El sol calienta ranchos anchos y de luz todos los baña. A esos campos van los niños campesinos. Sin vecinos, son peregrinos de verdad. Van de camino los veranos, inviernos y primaveras, cruzando estados y condados, ciudades extranjeras. Como las golondrinas van bajo los cielos, dándose vuelo, para anhelos de verdad. Van a los files de la uva, betabel y de manzana. Y ahí los niños se la pasan todo el día entre las ramas. De sol a sol hasta que llegan pagadores. Dándole flores para dolores de verdad. ¡Levántate! ¡Oh, pap! Como a las una, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis de la mañana. No quiero, levántate, cabrón. El sol calienta ranchos anchos y de luz todos los baña. Y a esos campos van los niños campesinos. Sin un vecino, son peregrinos de verdad. Pero algún día esos niños serán hombres y mujeres, trabajadores campesinos que defienden sus quereres. Y en mano en mano tomarán otro camino, con un vecino, son peregrinos de verdad. Como a las una, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis de la mañana. Ay, papi, no quiero. ¡Levántate! El sol calienta ranchos anchos y de luz todo lo baña. Y a esos campos solo van los esquiroles. ¡Viva la huelga, viva la huelga, viva la causa de verdad! Yeah, growing up as kids in the fields, you know. I mean, it was a very interesting experience, you know. So Cesar Chavez really changed our life. He changed the way we lived, the way we saw ourselves. He gave us back our dignity and a sense of who we were. And so as I grew older, and my wife and I started having kids, you know, we had our firstborn. I have three kids, and we had our first son, I was so delighted. I was off my feet, walking on air. So when she got pregnant the second time, I prayed to God. I said, yeah, I really want a daughter really bad. And in those days, they didn't have ultrasound. What we had was a needle. We had a needle that used to stick in front of the belly button of the woman. And if it moved in a certain direction, it told you whether it was a man or a woman, right? So we put it up to her stomach, and it's going to be a girl, said. So we went to the doctor, and he said, we're going to have a girl. He said, I don't think so. He says, I think you're going to have a boy. And I said, no, that's impossible. You know, we checked it with a needle. He said, well, I understand you're using all these old methods, but we don't do that kind of thing anymore. You know? And from what I know, my experience, you're going to have a girl. You're going to have a boy. I said, oh, come on. He said, well, you know, I'll take it up with God, he said. So that's what I did. I went, God? I said, I really want a girl really bad. Quiero una hija. And God said, okay, you want a girl? Write a song. I said, what? He said, write a song. So I sat down one afternoon, and I wrote a song about her name. And the due date came. We went to the hospital. It was a hell of a delivery, 24 hours around the clock. We're waiting. I'm in the delivery room waiting for the baby to come out, you know, and the doctors say, look, don't hold your hope. You got your hopes up too high, you know, it's going to be a boy. And we're sitting there, pop, it's a girl. I called her Primavera. Now the weight of winter's gone, and once again I see the sun, and the birds come out to sing, to tell the world she's home again. Man, stop and stare. The gaze of loveliness so rare that fills man with tranquility, oh, and love for all humanity. As she leaves, she sings a song that turns the leaves into a brown. For some is here, she can't stay. Well, that's life's long, and that's God's way. This next song is really an interesting piece. It's called A Better Day Will Come, Un Mejor Día Vendrá. It was written by James Taylor originally. I got the honor of actually writing the Spanish lyrics for it. There was a play on Broadway called Working by Studs Terkel, and it was about, well, workers. It was all about different kinds of workers, the steel workers, the textile workers. And there was a sequence in the actual play about farm workers. So I was asked to record the song, and it was part of the show and part of the video. But the amazing thing was that James, who I've been a fan of all of my life, I got an opportunity to meet him and talk with him and actually work on one of his songs. And so it was quite an experience to actually take a collaboration with James Taylor and actually work a song into Spanish. The song is called Un Mejor Día Vendrá. Ay, la, 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 la. Ay, la, 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 la. La, 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 la. La, 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 la. Cuando amanezca la tarde, vuelvo cansado a mi hogar. Y pensando en el futuro, olvido el dolor y pesar. ¿Dónde se ha ido mi vida? ¿Dónde se ha ido mi juventud? Perdidas en las palabras que el viento me trae, un día mejor vendrá. Un mejor día vendrá. Un mejor día vendrá, cuando Dios a los pobres su lugar dará. Cuando amanezca la tarde, vuelvo cansado a mi hogar. Y pensando en el futuro, olvido el dolor y pesar. ¿Dónde se ha ido mi vida? ¿Dónde se ha ido mi juventud? Perdidas en las palabras que el viento me trae, un día mejor vendrá. Un mejor día vendrá. Un mejor día vendrá, cuando Dios a los pobres su lugar dará.
You know, I had a tremendous opportunity and tremendous really chance to work with some incredible artists, you know, and one of the artists that I got an opportunity to actually not only work or perform with, but also do an album, was Linda Ronstadt. And I was telling Tony, I grew up as a fan of Linda Ronstadt. And I grew up with all her music. I was always a great fan. And so when we got a chance to meet each other, we hit it off. And it turns out, many years later, I found this out later, that Linda Ronstadt's family and my family were kind of linked together. My great-great-grandfather worked for her great-grandfather years and years and years ago. And my uncle, Lalo Guerrero, actually was Linda Ronstadt's godfather. So when we got together, and it was because of her father was very insistent that she get together with me and do something. So we had a chance to do something. I met Linda actually in a kitchen. I was running from photographers. It was the premiere of Zoot Suit. And I ran into this kitchen because all these people were chasing me. And Linda was in there. And I said, what are you doing in here, right? So we met for the first time then. So we became very good friends. And it took a few years before we had a chance to work together, but we finally did. We recorded this next song. Estás mirando el diario, nos miras pobre, no los miras con el arado, luego con la rosadera. Una vez en la llanura y otra vez en la ladera. Sol que tú eres tan parejo para repartir tu luz. Habías de enseñar y al amor hacer lo mismo que tú. Esta vida de los pobres es una vida ingrata, donde el rico tiene todo y el pobre no tiene nada. Sol que tú eres tan parejo para repartir tu luz. Habías de enseñar y al amor a hacer lo mismo que tú. And you know, I learned that song from a farm worker in Delano. He was the one that taught it to me. You know, those days at Delano were really incredible. You know, one of the things that we had to deal with was the picket sign, all right? What do you say picket sign in Spanish, right? What is the direct translation of picket sign, right? Una arma de guardia. I mean, what do you call it, right? So we were dealing with farm workers. We wanted to keep it. So we kept it very simple. We called it el picket sign. Desde Texas a California, campesinos están luchando. Desde Texas a California, campesinos están luchando. Los rancheros a llore y llore, de huelga y están mempando. El picket sign, lo llevo por todo el día. El picket sign, conmigo toda la vida. Un primo que tengo yo andaba regando diches. Un primo que tengo yo andaba regando diches. Un día con pagarulo y otro con sanabadiches. El picket sign, lo llevo por todo el día. El picket sign, conmigo toda la vida. Me dicen que soy muy necio, gritón y alborota pueblos. Me dicen que soy muy necio, gritón y alborota pueblos. Pero Juárez fue mi tío y Zapata fue mi suegro. El picket sign, lo llevo por todo el día. El picket sign, conmigo toda la vida. Hay muchos que no comprenden, aunque uno les da consejos. Hay muchos que no comprenden, aunque uno les da consejos. La huelga es un bien para todos, pero unos se hacen pendejos. El picket sign, lo llevo por todo el día. El picket sign, conmigo toda la vida. El picket sign, lo llevo por todo el día. El picket sign, conmigo toda la vida. Hermanos y campesinos, aquí les vengo a cantar. Les hablo de César Chávez, canto de nuestra unidad. Con un dedo no haces nada, tú ni puedes trabajar, ni con dedos separados, si la mano abierta está. Pero si los dedos se unen, la mano vas a cerrar. La unión es como esa mano, con fuerza para luchar. Nuestra unión hace la fuerza, nuestra fuerza hace la unión. Es nuestro pueblo marchando hacia la liberación. Con la unión se mata el miedo, hay valor en la hermandad. Pero hay que matar primero el miedo de la unidad. Eres una gota de agua y solo te has de secar. Pero el pueblo es como un río, como la lluvia y el mar. La unión es el río creciendo y todo se va a llevar. Es el contratista oyendo el agua de la libertad. Nuestra unión hace la fuerza, nuestra fuerza hace la unión. Es nuestro pueblo marchando hacia la liberación.
So the farm worker experience laid the foundation for who we were as a theater company and who we were as people. You know, we never thought of ourselves as actors. We thought of ourselves as activists, right? So we realized it was a combination of both things, because our act was to go out and protest. So we became activists, right? And so in the process of evolving our theater company, we moved into new themes. We wanted to talk about urban reality and talk about pachucos. We wanted to talk about the street figures. We wanted to talk about the Chicano who called themselves a Chicano. Who was he? Years later, it would all culminate in a motion picture that we finally did called Zoot Suit. But I'd like to do a poem for you. It was written by a very famous poet who passed recently. He's been dead a couple of years now, who wrote about the experiences of pachucos. It's called El Uy.
Yo soy el muchacho alegre que me amanezco cantando con mi botella de vino. Y los muchachos tocando.
Hoy enterraron a Uy. En San Pedro, en San Pinche, are in for it. And those times of the 40s and early 50s had lost un vato de atoye.
Voy a contarles un corrido muy chateado. Lo que ha pasado allá en el barrio de La Flor. La triste historia de un pachuco enamorado. Que fue borracho y parandero y jugador.
Kind of slim and drawn there towards the end, aging too fast from too much booze y la vida dura, but class to the end. In Sanjo, you'd see him sporting his black top coat, playing in his fantasy the role of Bogart, Cagney the Raft. Ebe Fowler, el vato, el carnal del candy, el ponche, the West Side knew him. Even Selma and Gilroy, 48 Fleet Line, two-tone, buenas garras.
And always rucas como la Helen y la Mary. Y siempre con liras bien afinadas cantando la palma, la que andaba en el florero.
En el mar está una palma con las ramas hasta el suelo. Donde se van a llorar los que no encuentran consuelo, pobrecita de la palma.
You know, Louis hit on the idea for tailor-made drapes in those days, and the idea was unique, porque Fowler no era nada como los, ni el old EPT.
Fresno's West Side was as close as we ever got to the big time. But we had Louis, El Palomar, y El Boogie, Los Mambos y Los Cuatro Suspiros del Alma. Uno, dos, one, two, tres, cuatro. Pero nunca faltaba that familiar butt drinking, butt uptight feeling. Trucha, get Louis, man, va a haber pedo. Y un día domingo que se andaba emborrachando, a la cantina le corrieron a avisar. Cuídate, Luis, que por ahí te andan buscando. Son muchos vatos, no te van a filería. Ay, la, 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 la. No llores, Carmen, we can take them. Get Louis, man, hurry up. Va a haber chingazos in the parking lot away from the jura. Traes filero, Simón, chale. Este vato. But Louis would always come through like melodramatic music, just like in the mono. Ta-da, ta-da. Cruz Diablo, el charro negro, aja. Smile more deadly than his visas. He dug roles, man. And names like Blackie, Little Louis. Ese Louis! Chale, man. Just call me Diamonds. Me voy de soldado raso. Voy a ingresar a los filas. Con los valientes muchachos que dejan madres queridas, que dejan novias llorando, llorando su despedida. And in Korea, fue el soldado de levita con huevos, with all the paradoxes of el soldado raso, heroism and the stockade. And on leave, jumpboots chinadas, ribbons cocky from the war, strutting to early mass on Sunday morning. Wow, is that old Louis? Ay, mira, comadre, ahí va el hijo de Lola. Creí que tu vida era mía y que tú me querías como yo te quiero a ti. Afterwards, he and Fat Richard would hawk their bronze stars for pisto in El Jardín Canales, in El Trocadero. At Barber College, woo, he came through con honores. Después que meñaba su pelardo de la peluca para jugar poker cerrada en Lobo, in Sanjo y Alviso. And Legs Louis Diamond hit on some lean times. Hoy enterraron a Louis. Cante. La ilusión de mi anhelo hubo sol en mi cielo y alegría en mi vivir. Y ahora, at Nisi's Pool Parlor, los baby chucks se acuerdan de Louis, el carnal del candy, el ponche, la vez que lo filerearon allá en la casa Dome y otra vez que se cateó con la chiva. Hoy enterraron a Louis. But his death was an insult. Porque no murió en acción. No lo mataron los vatos, ni los chinos en Korea. He died alone in a rented room, perhaps like in a Bogart movie. The end was a cruel hoax, an overdose. But his life had been remarkable. Un vato de Atoye, el Louis Rodríguez. Yo soy el muchacho alegre que me amanezco cantando con mi botella de vino. Y los mariachis tocando. You know, in 1978, we got a pamphlet in the mail from a group, or actually from a guy who had been involved in the first, it was called the Sleepy Lagoon murder case. And it was a pamphlet about so what, and it was the story of the Sleepy Lagoon murder case that happened in 1942, in which 22 Chicanos were indicted for one murder. And it was really a war on a new identity. Because for the first time, at least in Chicano history, in Mexican history, a whole generation was calling themselves something else. They weren't calling themselves Mexican Americans. They were calling themselves Chicanos. This is the era of the Pachuco. Who is the Pachuco? He is the firstborn of a lot of those Mexican families who came over from Mexico, who were born here in the United States, who didn't identify necessarily with Mexico. They identified with the United States, and they called themselves Pachucos, Chicanos. Well, it was part of a craze that was crossing the country. Big bands were happening. You know, we had Glenn Miller. We had all kinds of music that was exploding in the country. There was an identity crisis actually taking place in the country. We're in the middle of a war with Japan. There's tremendous ironic things that were happening. There was a race thing that was taking place. You know, and Japanese families were being interned and taken to the internment camps. And Chicanos were in the middle of all this. And all around the country, a whole generation of young people decided to put on a zoot suit and really become hip, become Bonnaroo. And they identified with Glenn Miller and all those big band leaders who led a whole generation into a whole different part. There was a guy named Cab Calloway who wore the first zoot suit. And he wore, and as a matter of fact, he was dressed in white. That left an imprint. And for Chicanos, it was absolutely unbelievable. So the whole zoot suit era began. And in that process, the story of Sleepy Lagoon took place. I'd like to do a number now from that play.
Mighty marijuana, mighty marijuana, boogin'. Mighty marijuana, mighty marijuana, boogin'. Mighty marijuana, that's my baby's name. Put on your drips, ese vato, make those calcos shine. Put on your drapes, ese vato, make those calcos shine. They're holding court on the corner, it's marijuana boogie time. Mighty marijuana, mighty marijuana boogie. Mighty marijuana, mighty marijuana boogie. Mighty marijuana, that's my baby's name. Got a woman named Juana, whoa, Juana. But all the men she's made love to, they call her marijuana. Mighty marijuana, that's my baby's name. Mighty marijuana boogie. Mighty marijuana, mighty marijuana boogie. Mighty marijuana, that's my baby's name.
Woo! You know that National Convention, National Organization of Marijuana, you know, they've been doing it all around the country. They actually asked me if they could use that song as their theme piece, right? So of course I said yes.
Carnal, póngase abusado, ya los tiempos han cambiado. Usted está muy agüitao, de este booty atravesado. Antes te bailaba el swing, boogie woogie jitterbug.
pero eso ya torció y esto es lo que sucedió. Los chucos suaves bailan la rumba y le zumban, bailan guaracha sabrosón, el botecito y el danzón. Los chucos suaves bailan la rumba y le zumban, bailan guaracha sabrosón, el botecito y el danzón. Rapa pa para para, y para pa 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 pa, y pa 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 pa, y te da ta pa pa pa. Carnal, póngase abusado, ya los tiempos han cambiado. Usted está muy agüitao, de este buti atravesado. Antes se bailaba el swing, boogie boogie jitterbug, pero eso ya torció y esto es lo que sucedió. Los chucos suaves bailan la rumba y le zumban, bailan guaracha sabrosón, el botecito y el danzón. Los chucos suaves bailan la rumba y le zumban, bailan guaracha sabrosón, el botecito y el danzón. Bam, ta, tiddling, da, bam, doop, da, bam, boom, boom, bam, rupo, pa, du, 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 bam, you, da, da, tiddling, da, doom, ba, ba, du, du, ba, ba, you, pa, da, ba, boom, 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 y te da, ba, ba, boom, ba, ba, you, pa, 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 pa. Carnal, póngase abusado, ya los tiempos han cambiado. Usted está muy agüitao, de este abute atravesado. Antes se bailaba el swing, boogie, boogie, jitterbug, pero eso ya torció y esto es lo que sucedió. Los chucos suaves bailan la rumba y le zumban, bailan guaracha sabrosón, el botecito y el danzón. Los chucos suaves bailan la rumba y le zumban, bailan guaracha sabrosón, el botecito y el danzón.
Thank you. This next song is written by a Cuban composer. His name is Silvio Rodriguez. And during the 70s and 80s, he recorded some incredible music. And, you know, it's making contact with international folk singers and writers really, really opened my eyes to the kind of music that was happening all around the world. But I fell in love with one of his songs that I'd like to do for you now. It's called El Rey de las Flores. El Rey de las Flores lo conocí por la tarde. Hace un tiempo me llamó la atención su tono de arco iris en la piel, su corona de papel. El Rey de las Flores tiene sus fábricas dentro de la tierra, 2 pulgadas detrás del sol, cada inquilino en una flor, en cada piso está el amor. El Rey de las Flores tiene lagartos que cantan de salto en salto. Tiene batallones de abejas chiquitas y arañas babosas y aves bonitas. El Rey de las Flores lo conocí por la tarde. Hace un tiempo me llamó la atención su tono de arco iris en la piel, su corona de papel. El Rey de las Flores tiene lagartos que cantan de salto en salto. Tiene batallones de abejas chiquitas y arañas babosas y aves bonitas. Sobre los floridos campos del Rey de las Flores veo mi hijo y llamándola hay una voz. Quedó partido en 2 mitades por una bomba que cayó. Sobre los floridos campos el Rey de las Flores veo a mi hijo y llamándola hay una voz quedó partido en dos mitades por una bomba que cayó.
So we've been through a lot of changes in our life. You know, the Chicano movement was a big, big change in all of our lives, discovering not only who we were, but the struggles that we were faced with. You know, I don't have to tell you the history of what happened here in Denver when the Chicano movement broke out. You know, there was so much violence in the street, so much resistance to the changes that were taking place. You know, I actually came to Denver for the first time in 1967. I was 17 years old. We were on our way to New York, and we stopped. It was our first stop. I'd never been out of California before, and our first stop was here in Denver. And I met a man who later not only would influence my whole life, but became part of my family in every respect of the word. His name was Corky Gonzalez, Corky Rodolfo Gonzalez, yes. The most incredible man I'd ever met. And the one thing he gets to tell me is you can't give up. You have to hope. You have to nourish that vote, that hope, and keep it alive. Because that's the only thing we got, is hope. So when I wrote my first album, you know, one of the first things that came to me was I wanted to do a tribute to that struggle. So I wrote this song, which was on my first album, called Broken Hopes. Many times in life it seems that happiness is just a dream. Just a dream that leads nowhere but disappears in despair. Though we've seen our hopes broken, we must go on and endure the time to come for our struggle to be won. So we wait throughout the year, listening to our children's tears, tears of pain that make us wise and bring strength into our lives. Though we've seen our hopes broken, we must not fear and believe we have that prayer that God in our hearts can hear. When at last, when we can see that happiness can really be, it will come for all mankind when happiness has filled our lives. Though we've seen our hopes broken, we must go on and endure the time to come for our struggle to be won. For our struggle to be won. For our struggle to be won. El indio de Huesu y Sangre is far from vanished. The the flesh has merely been torn from the skeleton of America Indigena, but the Indio lives on in agony. But suddenly there's a warmth as broad and as wide and as deep as this continent, and all of America becomes our home, our birthright, our struggle. Son of the earthquake is dying. Tells of a new world to come. White-bearded strangers arriving. Out of the heart of the sun. Hands grasping weapons of vengeance, screaming volcanoes of tears. Ancient America rising, end of her prophecy near. Bam 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 da dum dum bam ba e na dum da dum dum ba e na dum na dum dum bam ba e da da ba 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 surcando el cielo de América, sangre de viento avanzando, forma de fuego en la noche, en ruinas y ahí. Canto del llanto del indio, voces del tambor tocando, flautas que hablan con Dios, me dicen así. Sangre, fusil y la tierra, gritando revolución. Flautas que hablan con Dios, me dicen así. Bam bam bam, bam 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 bam, yidaram, yarim bum bam, yidaram, dam bum bam bam, yida ba 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 ba. Manos de bronce en la tierra, flor de sudor van sembrando, esperanzas de los pobres nacen aquí. Corazón, amor tajado, caras de piedra se ven, niños llenos de tormenta han de nacer. Sangre, fusil y la tierra, gritando revolución. Niños llenos de tormenta, han de nacer. Bam, 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 tam, bum, bum, bam, bam, y ba, bam, bam, bum, bam, y da, dam, dam. Los indios, su isla explosivo llegó. Ya van bajando los pueblos hacia la liberación. Sangre, fusil y la tierra, gritando revolución. Ya van bajando los pueblos hacia la liberación, hacia la liberación, hacia la liberación.
Thank you.
bailar la bamba, para bailar la bamba se necesita una poca de gracia, una poca de gracia pa' mi patilla, y arriba, y arriba, ay, arriba, y arriba, y arriba iré, por ti seré, yo no soy marinero. Yo no soy marinero, soy capitán, soy capitán, soy capitán. Va la bamba, va la bamba, va la bamba, va. Para bailar la bamba, para bailar la bamba, se necesita una poca de gracia, una poca de gracia pa' mi patilla, y arriba, y arriba, ay, arriba, y arriba, y arriba iré, por ti seré, por ti seré. Va la bamba, va la bamba, va la bamba. Para bailar la bamba, para bailar la bamba se necesita una poca de gracia pa' mi patilla, y arriba, y arriba, y ahí arriba, y arriba, y arriba iré, por ti seré, por ti seré. Everybody. Bamba, bamba, yeah. Bamba, bamba, bala, bamba, bamba.
Thank you. One more time. Come on, baby.
Para bailar la bamba, para bailar la bamba, se necesita una poca de gracia, una poca de gracia pa' mi batía, y arriba, y arriba, ay, arriba, y arriba, y arriba iré, por ti seré, por ti seré.
Everybody.
Va. Soy marinero, yo no soy marinero, soy capitán, soy capitán, soy capitán. Va la bamba, va la bamba, va la bamba, va.
Para bailar la bamba, para bailar la bamba, se necesita una poca de gracia, una poca de gracia pa' mi patria. Y arriba, y arriba, ay, arriba, y arriba, y arriba iré, por ti seré, por ti seré.
Bamba, bamba, bala, bamba, bala, bamba.
Hey, yeah. Buenas noches.